Bill Cosby. First, I want to talk about Michael Brown or Ferguson, the Ferguson situation. When that story first broke, story of an unarmed black teenager being shot by a white cop. The cop reported that Mike Brown basically attacked him and he was defending himself. And there were other reports that the cop shot Michael Brown when his hands were up or when he was running away, and the evidence sort of contradicted that. And so since then, you had pretty much two sides form. And I thought it was interesting in the beginning, even right from the beginning, you had the peaceful protesters, and then you also had people from outside the community going in, looting and destroying property. In fact, a lot of the people who were arrested were pretty much outside of the community, or from outside of the community. So that had me wondering whether, were these just agitators? Were these people who were being encouraged to go into this area and start some trouble? And who was doing the encouraging if they were being encouraged? Okay, so now we have the decision, the grand jury. The grand jury is going to decide whether they're going to indict this officer or not. And you have the media almost promoting it, like almost hyping people, almost encouraging people to do something if there's a certain decision by the grand jury. I find it to be very odd, very, very odd indeed. It's strange how they're really covering this. Almost like people want young black people to go out there and do something stupid. Now, here's the thing, whether I agree with you on this particular case or not, going out and destroying property isn't going to help anybody in the long run, okay? If people want to protest, hey, you have every right to do so peacefully, okay? And that's a right that we should all respect, including law enforcement. On the other hand, we should not be limiting law enforcement in their abilities to actually protect others. And we shouldn't be telling them, oh, well, we don't want you to interfere with this looting and this rioting. Look, people still have a right to their property. They have a right to protest, and they also have a right to their property. I don't think it's fair that they're telling certain law enforcement in certain situations that they shouldn't interfere. Look, let them do their jobs, okay? If people want to riot or people want to loot or destroy things, there should be consequences. They shouldn't just allow people to run around and destroy property and threaten others and just create chaos. There should be law and order, okay? You have to find that balance. Yes, there's liberties, there's rights. Yes, we should protect that. But on the other hand, that doesn't mean sit back and let the city burn, okay? So I hope they keep that in mind. So share your thoughts about that. Do you think the media is trying to promote something to happen in Ferguson? I mean, it's so wide. I think people need to be smarter about how they respond to situations like this. Think long-term, think of sustainable change. Okay, I heard a lot of black people on YouTube talk about, oh, this is why you gotta vote and all this stuff. Well, if all I gotta do is show up and vote for some white Democrat or some black Democrat, as I've seen pretty much all my life, and these are basically the same characters who are implementing the corruption and the problems we already have in our own community right now. And if that's all you're gonna do, then that's not really doing anything proactive, okay? Somebody said you should run for office. Well, okay, that makes a little bit more sense. But if we're just gonna continue doing the same old, then I don't see that as being a solution. I think economic development, economic freedom, is a better course. If you don't like the way things are going, develop things economically instead of focus on destroying something. Because all you're gonna do by destroying things is just ruin your own image and put yourself in a situation where you can end up in a criminal justice system and you'll be in a weaker position. Anyway, Bill Cosby. Man, when I was growing up watching the Cosby Show, I gotta tell you, man, this show definitely had a huge influence on me. I really enjoyed this show. Seeing this patriarch, seeing this black man hitting his family, just being the type of father that, if I ever wanted to be a father, I would want to be like that character. I definitely respected this man. And now, apparently it turns out women have been accusing this guy of rape for years. Now, that's just one or two. Women looking for fame. I don't know what's going on here. I'm not saying the man's guilty, but now we have Janice Dickinson, some ex-model, saying this guy did something to her, tried something with her. There's multiple reports, multiple claims that he used drugs to rape women. He basically consistently tried to rape women according to these reports, these accusations. And it's strange how similar they are. It's almost like a pattern, like it's like an MO, like a consistent pattern over and over, almost at the same mode of operation. Do I know this guy is guilty or not? No, I don't. But when you have 12 accusers, you have to be honest with yourself and say, something's not right right here. I'm not saying he's guilty. I'm not going to say he's not guilty. But you know, you have to get to a point where even if you respect somebody a lot, you have to look at the facts. And that's all I try to tell people, and I have to do that myself. I am very disappointed to hear about this. I think the man... I would say he should have his day in court, but I don't think there's going to be a case right here. What do you guys think of this situation? Because you, on one hand, you have people accusing, but there's no real physical evidence. But at what point do you say, okay, this is too many people accusing one person of the exact same thing? I'm still just trying to process this. Like, Bill Cosby raping people? Like, I would have never thought of that. It's a few months ago. I don't agree with everything he had to say. You know, I agree with a lot of stuff he had to say about the black family and fatherless homes in this country. Didn't agree with his stance on guns. It is kind of weird how these accusations come out, and it sort of forces you to reexamine every single thing you ever heard the guy say. Like, I don't know if that's ever happened to you before. And I just think it's important that we don't try to convict anybody. You know, even the officer who shot Michael Brown, I think we should try to avoid treating someone as if they're guilty until they've actually been proven guilty. That's something that's really important to me. All right, one last thing. One thing I discovered is that with these AK magazines, you got to make sure that every magazine goes into every single AK that you have. Because I found one magazine that fit with this mil-spec rifle, but then not so much in this rifle. And the reason why is because this was this one right here was a mil-spec manufacturer. It's a new manufacturer. This right here is a parts gun. This was designed to only take single stack magazines, and they use in here in the US they actually open it up so that you can put in bigger magazines, double stack magazines inside. As a result, it's not necessarily mil-spec, which is why that magazine didn't quite fit in there that well. So I had to get rid of that magazine. I want to make sure that all my magazines fit into every single gun I have, whether they're mil-spec or not, because if something goes out, I can't be like, okay, is this the magazine that can go into this gun or not? Anyway, I just want to put my thoughts out there, guys. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. Wow. Bill Cosby. Don't forget the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.